It's time to turn into action figure form. I'm expecting the Mandalorian. I have been expecting you.
Yes, indeed. I've brought the Imperials one of the best car paints on the planet. If Kitty Boy Stores can apply that to my armor, this is the way.
Yes, this is the way. Hello everyone, today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to repaint your own Mandalorian. First of all, before you start painting, you do need to learn your figure. So I learned where I can pull off and not pull off. I was able to pull off the Mandalorian head after heating him up, but I pulled just his head. I wanted to pull his neck and head out, which I did see on another person's video. So I pulled it from the neck up using a pliers while it was heated from boiled water. After I taped the neck off with masking tape, and I used Spaztic's Gloss Black. It's a black backer. And what this does is it really makes the helmet super duper glossy. And the reason why I'm spraying it black is because I used the Spaztic's Mirachrome. And the only way to get the Mirachrome to work is by having this black backer. So you don't need any primer. You just spray the black backer straight onto the plastic. And then you go with your airbrush with the Mirachrome by Spaztic's. And you spray the Mirachrome all over the head. I went like maybe 6 inches away from the head. And when you're applying the black backer too, don't go spraying like long times at a time. Just light strokes, just with the black backer until you're happy with the black that you see. And then with the Mirachrome, you just keep going until you're happy with what you see here. So I was happy with that. You let it dry for about maybe half an hour, and you come back with a cloth and you can buff out the Mirachrome. So when you buff it out with a towel, you lightly wipe the helmet and you can actually see your own reflection after you wipe it down. So after wiping it down, you can see the reflection on the helmet is a lot more crisp. Looks more chromish. It's not fully chrome because I did weather it down by applying some black wash and some brown wash, and I'll teach you guys how to make that later on. But right here, what I'm doing is I'm repainting the visor with just normal matted black. Opaque black. Going with a fine tip paintbrush and just applying the black to the helmet. And just a tip, guys, don't drink any caffeine before doing this. I had a pre-workout, and then so when I went to try to paint the visor, my hands were just trembling like crazy. It was so hard to paint the visor with shaky hands. So when you're doing fine areas like this, try to not drink any coffee or energy drink or pre-workout, because painting that will be a pain in the ass. So just a pointer there. Okay, and now we are getting to the black and brown wash. Way you make the brown and black wash is you just put a little bit of acrylic brown paint or black paint in the bowl, and you just put like maybe three or four drops of water and you mix it with the paint. So it gives you this really watery paint substance. And I just went with a fat brush and I painted all over the figure black, wiped it down with a napkin, then painted all over brown, and I just kept repeating the system and wiping it off with a napkin until I was happy with the weathering on the figure. And what I'm doing here right now is I'm going with my airbrush and I'm sealing the black wash and the brown wash, because over time your fingers playing with it, you'll wipe some black wash and brown wash off, because it's not really permanent. But to make it permanent, what I'm doing here is I'm sealing it with Vallejo matted, it's a matte clear coat, matte clear coat. So I'm just clear coating it down with a matte clear coat on my airbrush. Holy crap, I'm having a hard time talking today. And I'm doing the same thing with the cape over here. So this is a really easy project to do. Very simple. I think the hardest part is not dirtying your helmet too much to the point where you destroy the chrome on the helmet. But yeah, this is my take on how I did my Mandalorian. Alright, and taking a look at the Mandalorian, he looks super freaking cool. He looks so realistic. I just, oh man, I should have took a video of how he looked before. I'm probably sure the ones of you that have the Mandalorian action figure, you'll see a massive difference between the two. I mean, this guy just looks so awesome with the repaint. Not a bit of me regrets weathering this figure down or repainting this figure. He just looks incredible. He looks very realistic. And I can't wait for the SH Figure Arts Mandalorian to come out, because I'm definitely going to pick that guy up. But yeah, it just looks, look at that. Look at the helmet. Like, you can see somewhat of a reflection. I did weather it to the point where it dumbed down the reflection big time. I did not want the helmet to look new. But you can definitely see reflection in the helmet. So that is so freaking cool. If you want to, you can make your helmet more chromed out and less weathering, so that we have a more shiny look. But for me, I like the dirty look. I hope they do, and I'm pretty sure they will come out with the armored Mandalorian version. And if the chrome isn't to my liking, I'll definitely be redoing the chrome on his armor as well. Yeah, looking at the weathering on his body, see the shoulders a lot more dirty. I really like the weathering. It really brings out the detail in the sculpt. And I've watched two other YouTubers do this. I forgot their names, but I did pick up the weathering from them. But the Spastix chrome, that's completely 100% my idea. And even the cape too, I weathered the cape with a lot of brown and black wash. I didn't like how light the brown was on the cape, so I darkened the cape a lot. I really like how dark the cape came out. Looks less like plastic and more like cloth from afar. But yeah, definitely super cool. Look at that. Oh man, just can't get over the helmet. It's just super freaking cool. And with that said, tell me what you guys think. Tell me if you guys are gonna customize your own Mandalorian when you do get it. This is the Hasbro Black Series Mandalorian, for those of you who have been asking. And yes, I really do not regret repainting this guy at all, just because he looks so freaking badass. So with that said, if you guys have any other questions, comment below the box. And once again, guys, if I already answered your question in the video, please watch the whole video, because I'm not going to comment back, because it's irrelevant for me to do that. And if you are kids watching this channel, back off, because I will be blocking your accounts if you guys keep stating that you guys are kids. That's really stupid for you guys to do that, because you guys are going to get one of us toy reviews or any YouTuber sued if you keep watching our content, so back off. And if you do, get a parent involved and have your parent watching with you. Anyways, with that said, if you haven't had time yet, check me out on my Instagram, Kenny Boys Toys with the Z in the middle on Instagram. Information will be in the description box below. Follow me there. And if you have not liked this video or subscribed to my channel yet, I suggest you do, for I'm always posting up cool content like these. Thanks for watching, guys, and have a great day.